Don't you think we should tell Charmless that it's about time we got back to the castle?
If that Charmless geezer don't call it a day soon, we're never gonna get the magic mirror. I reckon we should take him aside and tell him straight. Time to go, Charmless.
This is slowing us down too much. We need to persuade Charmless to go back to the castle so that we can get the magic mirror from Clavius. If we don't hurry, Dormagus might leave the Dark Ruins, and then we'll be back to square one.
There you are, and you've arrived just in time. Without further ado, allow me to present my new Argon Heart. The biggest you ever saw. I mean, you've seen a real Argon Heart for yourselves. You can tell this is no fake. I suppose you're wondering where I acquired it. Well, as luck would have it, one of the peddlers was selling one.
Service is our motto. We got another if you got the money.
Another? One is quite enough. Anyway, you can keep the Argon Heart from the Royal Hunting Ground for yourselves. I'm going to take this one back to the castle. You'll stay quiet about this, of course. And once the bazaar moves on, I won't need to worry about that peddler telling anyone. It's a flawless plan. Well, this is farewell. I'm off to the castle. Drop by sometime if you'd like to see the adoration on my subjects' faces firsthand. Ta-ta!
Oh, Charmles. What have you done?
Thank you. Prince Charmles, please show us the Argon Heart you obtained.
Why, it's enormous!
I've never seen such a big Argon Heart before. It must be the biggest in the history of the initiation.
He must have slain quite an Argon Lizard to get a heart of that size.
Prince Charmles, present the Argon Heart, symbol of your bravery and worthiness, to King Clavius.
No. Wait. Charmles, do you swear before the Almighty Goddess that you obtained this Argon Heart from an Argon Lizard slain by your own hand?
Of course, Father.
Because even if, for example, you were assisted by others in battle, I would still recognize your claim to the throne. But if you obtained it by any other means, I could not recognize your right to the throne. Is that perfectly clear?
Yes, of course. I fought the lizard with my own hands, and a frightful beast it was, too.
Very well, then I congratulate you. I accept this Argon Heart as proof of your true character. I saw my son take an Argon Heart from one of the merchants. Did you even take him to the royal hunting ground? I saw everything from up here. You must tell me the truth. Out with it! I see. So this is the Argon Heart he obtained with your help. Why didn't he simply show it to me? I would not have cared about the size. I fear this means Charmles is far too immature to take the throne, or a wife. However, that is a matter between Charmles and myself. You did a fine job in taking him to the royal hunting ground. The magic mirror is in the royal vault on the fourth floor. You are free to take it whenever you wish. I have already instructed the guards to admit you. And I will take this Argon Heart. It might prove useful when I need to remind Charmles of his foolhardiness.
Thank you. You've brought the magic mirror, if I'm not mistaken. May I have a look? That's odd. I don't sense any magic at all. Bereft of its magic power, it's no different from a normal, everyday mirror. Could someone have snuck in and tampered with the mirror while it slumbered in the royal vault? No, surely not. Nevertheless, even without its magic, the mirror remains a priceless royal treasure. What's that? The magical power of the mirror is central to your errand, you say? I see. Let me think. The mirror itself does not appear to be damaged. In which case, you should be able to recharge the mirror, so to speak, by exposing it to the right kind of magic. That would restore its former power. The man who taught me was a wizard and an expert in magical treasures. I'm sure he would know how to re-energize the mirror. Unfortunately, he is retired. Now he spends his days in seclusion in his home deep in the western forest.